गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास एट, वी वर रीडिंग चैप्टर 5 कम्बशन एंड फ्लेम। इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव अंडरस्टूड अबाउट कम्बशन एंड फ्लेम, अबाउट सम रिएक्शंस ऑफ कम्बशन, कंडीशंस नेसेसरी फॉर कम्बशन सच एज कम्बिस्टिबल एंड नॉन कम्बिस्टिबल सब्सटेंसेस, प्रेजेंस ऑफ सपोर्टर ऑफ कम्बशन, इग्निशन और किंडलिंग टेम्परेचर। वी हैव अंडरस्टूड अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ कम्बशन, अबाउट फ्लेम, अबाउट अ कैंडल फ्लेम, अबाउट फ्यूल, अबाउट कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू ऑफ फ्यूल, अबाउट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ अ गुड फ्यूल। Now in this class we are going to study about burning of fuels generates harmful products. So students, open page number 74 in your science book and keep a pencil with you to underline hard words. Now I'm going to read. The gaseous product such as carbon dioxide or carbon monoxide and particulate matter such as ash, soot, etc. produced by the burning of fuels affect the environment in many ways. So, burning of fuels generates harmful products. There are also some fuels whose burning emits carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, ash and lamp black, which are harmful to the environment. Now the points. Number one point, on burning fuels like coal, wood, petroleum, etc., release unburned carbon particles in the environment. These fine particles cause respiratory problems such as asthma. Moreover, wood is procured from the trees, excessive cutting of which leads to deforestation and various environmental hazards. If oxygen supply is insufficient, coal on burning forms carbon monoxide, which is a poisonous gas and can suffocate and kill people exposed to it. So, underline the word suffocate, which means inability to breathe, deforestation means cutting of forest or tree, insufficient means less amount of, so we have understood in first point that some fuels such as coal, petroleum and wood give carbon particles when burned. These small carbon particles go inside our body through our nose and are responsible for asthma disease, which is a respiratory disorder. Apart from this, burning of wood reduces the wood and it causes a lot of smoke. In the same way, if the coal is burned in less oxygen, then it produces carbon monoxide, which is a poisonous gas and can suffocate and kill people exposed to it. Now turn this page. Second point, incomplete combustion of liquid fuels like petrol, kerosene and diesel produces poisonous gas and soot. Soot means carbon particles or lamp black. Third point, you have already learned that complete combustion of most fuels releases carbon dioxide, water and heat energy. Carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas and is responsible for global warming, that is rise in the average surface temperature of the atmosphere of the earth. This in turn leads to many problems like melting of glacier and rise in the sea level, causing floods in the coastal areas. So we have understood that you have already read that if a fuel is completely combusted, it releases carbon dioxide and water. Carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas that is responsible for global warming. Our earth gets warm due to increase of carbon dioxide gas. It leads melting of glacier and rise in the sea level, which causes floods in the coastal areas. Now point 4. Fuels like coal and diesel have sulfur as impurity, which upon combustion forms sulfur dioxide, a very poisonous and corrosive gas. Petrol engines upon incomplete combustion of petrol form oxides of nitrogen and carbon, which pollute the atmosphere. These oxides of nitrogen and sulfur dissolve in rainwater and form acid rain. Such rain is very harmful to crops, soil, buildings, etc. So here you have to underline, corrosive means destructive. Impurity means dust. So we have seen in this point that some fuels such as coal, diesel, petrol upon combustion form oxides of nitrogen and sulfur, which are very poisonous and very corrosive to our environment. These oxides combine with other vapor, water vapor of atmosphere, and form acid rain. Acid rain is very harmful to crops, soil, buildings, etc. Is that clear? Nowadays, CNG, compressed natural gas, full form of CNG is compressed natural gas, has proved to be a better fuel than any of the solid or liquid fuels mentioned earlier. CNG burns completely without leaving any residue. It has a high calorific value and low ignition temperature. So, of all the fuels mentioned so far in this chapter, CNG is considered the best fuel. CNG has a very less ignition temperature with very high calorific value and is a pollution free gas. Now here you can see some questions. You have to answer them orally. And here you can discuss this question with your classmates, that it is always advised not to sleep in a closed room with burning coal fire. Discuss why. Now in the next class we will study about principle of extinguish fire. So that's all for today, students. Thank you, class.